For a lot of us, becoming a millionaire or a multimillionaire may be a lifetime goal or a dream, whether to retire early, get a job or pursue a hobby that we're passionate about, or just buy nicer things for ourselves. Now, no one's going to argue that becoming a millionaire is no longer an achievement, as even today, one only has to make $32,400 per year to be part of the top 1% of income earners in the entire world. So, it's no doubt that millionaires land in a very elite percentile. However, the truth is, the world around us has grown exponentially, and though becoming a millionaire is still a great milestone, I don't think it's the end goal, and here's why. Starting off, looking back at history, millionaire is actually quite an old word. It was first coined in French in 1719, but the earliest written use of the word in English wasn't until 1816. The word actually gained a lot of traction during the Industrial Revolution in the early 1800s, as large business owners would reach the acclaimed figure. But really, the golden age of becoming a millionaire was the Gilded Age, which was a period of high economic growth within the US in the late 1800s. Taking a look at the use of the word over time, we can see that this is really when people start to fancy the idea of becoming a millionaire. In fact, since then, the use of the word has actually declined quite a bit. In our generation, the growing word is actually billionaire. But anyways, the Gilded Age was when becoming a millionaire was the ultimate dream. Kids growing up and young entrepreneurs often looked up to millionaire leaders of the age, like JP Morgan, Andrew Carnegie, Rockefeller, and Henry Ford. And they wanted to eventually reach the same level of success. Flash forward 120 years, many of us are still looking to reach this same amount. But the fact is, the value of becoming a millionaire hasn't been cut in half, or quartered, or even cut in eight. Becoming a millionaire today is over 30 times less valuable. Aiming to become a millionaire today is equivalent to a kid born in the late 1800s hoping to make $33,000. Today, we have to make $30 million to become what originally meant to just become a millionaire. And that's not even taking into account the vast expansion of opportunities over the past century. Our lifestyles have evolved over the past century, which has introduced a wide array of new expenses that didn't exist 100 years ago. For instance, internet access itself would cost $25,000 over 40 years. Cell phone service would be another $25,000. And what about cars? Regular people didn't own cars 120 years ago. The average American family actually has more than two cars nowadays, with an average of 2.28. On top of this, the average car price in America is now $34,000. Even if you only owned two cars and replaced your cars once every 10 years, and also bought them at a significantly below average price of 20 grand, the cars themselves would cost you 160 grand over 40 years. Adding in another 40 grand for insurance, gas, and repairs, you'd be up $250,000 in expenses compared to someone in the 1900s. Something else to consider is that not only are there new expenses, but many traditional expenses have outpaced inflationary growth, with the most notable one being college. So clearly, aside from $1 million not being worth as much today, it also doesn't stretch very far. But you guys probably already knew that. And that brings me on to my third point, which is that virtually everyone in America earns well over $1 million during their lifetime. The median household income in America is $61,937. Over a regular 40-year career, this actually comes out to $2.477 million, or right about $2.5 million. Even working minimum wage, a person could make $1 million within a lifetime. Of course, virtually all of these people also don't have $1 million to show at the end of a lifetime of work. But this illustrates that becoming a millionaire is still rare, not because people don't earn enough, but because people don't save and invest enough. So, the only thing separating the average person from millionaire status is good financial habits. Considering this, is becoming a millionaire really a worthwhile lifetime goal? Isn't a dream supposed to be something that is nearly impossible to reach? Furthermore, the numerical value is not even the dream. The money is simply the means to achieve one's real dreams, whether that's luxury, financial safety or relaxation. And the thing is that none of those dreams can be achieved with $1 million, so it only makes sense that the numerical value should increase with our changing needs. We shouldn't settle for a simple numerical value of 1 million if it doesn't actually achieve the real goal. For instance, if we were to say that $400,000 a year to spend freely is a luxurious lifestyle, then we would not need 1 or 2 million, but $10 million invested in the stock market in order to be able to withdraw $400,000 per year indefinitely. This is because the stock market grows on average 7% per year, and experts have figured out that withdrawing 4% per year will leave you in a situation where you never run out, no matter how good or bad the economy is doing. Plus, while $400,000 a year can give you a nice lifestyle, it's not necessarily a luxurious life. Now, I'm not saying that having a lot of money will make you happy, though it will solve a lot of day-to-day problems. When people in the 1900s were working to become millionaires, or basically $30 million, through World War I, World War II, and the Great Depression, with monopolies like Standard Oil and AT&T controlling the market, it only makes sense that our ambitions are in the tens or hundreds of millions or even billions when accounting for inflation, additional expenses, and more opportunities. But that's just what I think. Drop a like if you guys have such big dreams. Also, consider subscribing to see more questions logically answered. But until then, I'm Hari, and I'll see you guys on the next one.